It's almost Friday and the weekend is coming, so let's cover the stories that need telling and inform you on the news that needs announcing. I'm Tyler Miller.
And I'm Joe Carrillo. Here are your news and announcements for today. If you caught the last show, then you heard us say that NHS applications are still being accepted. Unfortunately, they are not, so we take the blame for misinforming you since it's untrue. For that, we apologize.
It's that time of year again. Penn Choir's Sound of the Season concert will be taking place Thursday, December 11th and Friday, December 12th at 7:30 p.m. and also Sunday, December 14th at 3 p.m. All concerts will be held in the CPA. This year's concert will include holiday favorites from all the choirs and will give Penn Choir alumni the chance to relive memories and sing on stage. Tickets are $6 and $1 will go towards ALS research. Tickets will be available during all lunches this week and are also available online at www.ticketracker.com. Staff, if you are interested in watching, two complimentary tickets will be available for Thursday night show. Contact Fine Arts Ticket Manager Michelle Brown for any ticket requests.
If you are interested in taking the ACT on March 17th, remember that registration must be completed by December 19th. Any juniors who would like to sign up, you can sign up at the bookstore by paying $54.50. Korean Club will be having meetings on Black Wednesdays in room 226 after school until 4:15 p.m. Come ready to play Korean games, continue haggle lessons, and further pop culture knowledge.
Today, December 10th, is Human Rights Day. And in light of that, high schools all across the world will participate in letter-writing campaigns sponsored by Amnesty International. Penn Amnesty will be hosting their first letter-writing campaign this Friday, December 12th, until 4:30 p.m. in room 200. At this event, students will write to government officials who are violating or ignoring human rights. Food and drinks will also be provided. Bring your charged Chromebook and get ready to write. And now we'll head to a short break.
In dance to choreography.
We learn different techniques and styles of dance, and we also choreograph our end of the year dances for the showcase.
Probably the people most in the class with us, because there's a lot of talented dancers and it's just fun learning all the different stuff.
They should take this class because it teaches you all the elements of 2D art and because Mr. Vizat is a really good teacher. So if you're looking to have a fun time and to learn a whole bunch of 2D art, you should take this class.
I took this class because a lot of upperclassmen were talking about like how it's a fun class and how you can really see what you're made of.
Mrs. Kigney, she's like, during class, she's really good about helping you and demonstrating certain parts, like if you're really struggling, she'll, you know, come and sit with you and work on your project with you and try to help figure out what's best for the look that you want and kind of where you're going with your project and what it's going to look like if you keep going this way.
We make coil vessels, which are like vases made out of coils. Very, very fun.
I took photography because my grandpa's big into photography and art, and I always see him taking pictures, whether it's of my brothers or playing soccer or whatever.
Intro photography, you will learn how to use your camera, you will learn about the basics of art and design, and you will get to go through a lot of different projects that kind of test and let you exercise the different things you've learned in art.
The Penn Choir concert Sounds of Seasons takes the stage of the Penn CPA tonight, Friday, and Sunday. Penn Maestro Brent Holloway tells us what's in store.
Oh, it's hard to pick a favorite song, but I think probably traditionally Handel's Hallelujah Chorus that we finish the concert with might be one of my favorites. We also invite former choir members, our choir alumni, out of the audience, and they come right up on stage and join us for the final selection.
We also asked the choir members what their favorite songs were.
Well, our favorite song out of the chamber choir group is Dig That Crazy Santa Claus.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
It's so upbeat and it's full of energy, so we really like it.
The choir concert is sure to have a song that every listener will enjoy. Here's what other students' favorite songs are.
My favorite song is Let There Be Peace on Earth. It kind of reflects of how there's different communities and how we should all band together instead of being separate.
My favorite song this year is a rendition of Jingle Bells. It's very different than the traditional one that you'll hear on the radio. And I just really love it because it's something different and it's really upbeat and fun.
That song is a nightmare. I was going to say that. My favorite song is the one the concert choir is doing. It's called ODA. And it's just today, the Lord has risen today. We're saying that in Latin, not in English. But just the way it's written, it's just really obvious how at certain parts you need to get really excited about it. And it kind of like demands the performers to be excited about the entire time and to remember the message that's in the song. So.
My favorite song would have to be Let There Be Peace. It's a really great song and it has an awesome message, so yeah.
My favorite song is the Jingle All the Way medley because it's a bunch of classic Christmas songs mixed together and it picks up the pace and it gets really fun. So it's a lot of fun.
I really like the song Lullaby that all the girls sing together. It's really...
Guys sing it?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh yeah, they do. The guys sing it too. It's really like sweet and I just really like it a lot. It's really like flowy and it's just
awesome.
Nice.
Yeah.
The choir will be performing tonight, Friday, and Sunday. For PNN and Sienna McClellan, I'm Gary Babcoke.
Welcome back. Don't forget that the robotics team will be hosting the STC Robotics Competition on Sunday, December 14th. Come support your Penn Robotics team this Sunday. For more information, go to www.phmschools.org. Now we'll head to Tyler Clifton with sports.
Tuesday, the swimming and diving team competed against Washington. Grace Kaczynski covered the meet. Here she is with more.
On Tuesday, the Penn boys and girls swimming and diving team took on Washington at home. The Penn boys and girls look to continue to dominate after beating Clay last week in both boys and girls swimming and diving. The Penn boys took on Washington and won with the impressive score of 142-29 and the girls winning 150-23. The Penn boys and girls swimming and diving team look to their next opponent, Lake Central, this Saturday. They are seeking to improve their record, which stands at 2-1 for both boys and girls. For PNN, I'm Tayla Brown.
Thanks, Grace. The girls' basketball team had a game against Northwoods last night. We will have more next show. The men's basketball team plays Friday night at Concord. Good luck. The boys' wrestling has a match tonight against Elkhart Central at 7 p.m. here at Penn High School. Good luck to the boys' wrestling team tonight, and now back to the desk.
That looks like all the announcements we have for you today, Penn High School. I'm Tyler Miller.
And I'm Joe Carrillo. We hope that you have a fantastic Thursday, Penn High School.